you guys ever seen that video of the guy petting the pufferfish saying that weird doobie beautiful stuff at the beginning? Yeah, I realized I watched that on loop way too many times the night before I made these guys. But ultimately, for what they are, they kind of turned out kind of nightmare fuel-y. Especially when they all just wake up at the same time. These basically just have four animation clips on them. One for them to wake up. A lot of dead time, because, you know, I like to randomize timing. One for their rumble animation. One for them to poke out. The poke and the shrink clips both have events on them to trigger specific voids. We'll cover that when we get the script. Got a same event on this one. That's about it for the actual animations. This is the animator component. He goes from wake to rumble to poke to sleep back to awake. All the transitions are set for the change trigger. No time, nothing special on any of that. They're all exactly the same, with the exception of the any state action of poke. At any point, if the player makes contact with it, it triggers straight into poke and does an attack. Not just random, it can actually think a little bit. On the game object itself, we've got the rigid body 2D. We've got one collider for the actual physics, and one collider that is just a trigger. If you can run it off one collider, honestly I don't know how this works and doesn't seem to cause any problems, then we just have the script. On the script, we've got the particle system for the damage burst, which you may or may not want. We've got how much the thing does, how much damage the thing does, and we've got how much health it has. And we have the reference to the level miniature. Alright, once we get inside the script, we have privates for the collider, the rigid body, the animator. We've got variables for how much torque it gets when it starts spinning, the delayed timer, and how much delay is actually passed. We've got that game object for the damage burst, how much damage it actually does, how much health it has, and that reference to the level manager. In start, we grab the collider, the rigid body, and the animator. We set the timer to zero, and the delay is a random, because I like that, and because we all know chaos is a ladder. The delay for each animation clip is anywhere from half a second to 3 seconds. And finally, we get the game level manager. On to fix the update. Because these triggers take a while to actually turn themselves back off, and I'm using the same trigger to get from every different animation. When fixed update hits, I reset them all, so changes aren't automatic every fixed update, and timer is increased by delta time. If the timer has reached the delay time, that trigger is set for changing the animation. Timer is reset to zero, and the delay is reset to a new random delay time. Not a whole lot going on there. Now, on the animations that have the events on them, the animation for enlarging has the bigger, it increases the radius of the collider and adds some upward velocity to make it pop up when it expands. It's given a random torque range just to get it spinning for a range of speeds, so you never know exactly how this thing's going to react. And if random value is less than 0.5, then the torque is reversed in the opposite direction. After that, the torque is applied to the thing. I'm actually reducing the angular drag and the regular drag once it gets bigger so it can spin better and travel further. That's up to you if you want to do that or not. not. And for the growing and shrinking stage, I actually want longer random delays. So I reset the delay right here to a random 2 to 3 instead of 0.5 to 3. Just so it surely spins a little bit longer. And for the animation for the shrinking, I drop the radius back down to 0.5. I increase the drag so it's not spinning wildly without doing any damage. And that's about it for the actual script. The rest of that is just the basic interacting with the player on Collider 280. Or if it's a player, do whatever you want it to do to interact with your player. In my case, I set the trigger for poking to true so it instantly attacks the player regardless of where else it's, what other animation it's got going on. If it hits the player's attack box, have it do whatever you want it to do when it's actually taking damage.
Still here.